Well, as we approach the 50th Ranger Nick episode, so hard to believe, folks often ask me, Ranger Nick, how do you come up with the ideas for the show? Well, honestly, sometimes they just come to me. The light comes on in my mind. My son and I were spending some time out in the backyard not too long ago, summer evening, getting dark, fireflies are starting to flicker in the distance, and I wondered, how is it that their rear ends light up, and why do they light up? So I reached out to a friend of mine who's got the answers, happens to be a national expert in this, Dr. KATHRIN Stanger. Hall, Doc, good to see you and spend some time with you. So all the inquiring minds at home want to know, how is it that a firefly can light up like that? How does that happen?
Well, basically they do chemistry. So if you turn them around on their backside, what you see on their tummy is two yellow segments, and this is where the chemistry takes place.
Okay.
And all they need for that is an enzyme and a molecule that they transform.
Okay.
And then they add oxygen to the mix, and you get light emission.
And that's what they do. Lights up like that, and they light up. Who is they? Is this male, female, both? How does that work?
In many species, it's both males and females
okay.
that do that, and usually the males fly around searching for a potential mate sitting somewhere in the grass.
Okay.
They flash their species-specific little Morse code.
Okay, interesting.
And when the female recognizes the Morse code, she basically turns around and answers the male.
Interesting.
If the male sees it, the male responds, and so they engage in a courtship dialogue, and eventually they mate.
So it is a courtship thing. So the female is sitting over there, the male is trying his best to get her attention. Sounds very familiar to me how this works. This idea of flashing back and forth and then making a decision about whether or not to pair up. Well, what I want to do is I want to talk about how this faculty member studies fireflies and how they flash back and forth. And I want to go there next to kind of brighten everyone's day. So let's do that next. So here we're checking out some different species of fireflies that Dr. Stanger Hall studies. Just some examples there. And we learned a minute ago that we know that the male is the one that's communicating with the female, trying to get her attention, as is the case in many different species out there. If the female likes what she sees, she flashes that light back and things go from there. When does this begin in their life cycle? Do they have to be of a certain age to light that light or not?
Well, actually, the eggs already can light up as soon as they're laid.
Okay.
But then when the larvae hatch out, they can produce their own light. And they do that for about 1 to 2 years in the soil.
Really?
Pretty much whenever they get disturbed or somebody threatens them as a potential predator.
Interesting. So if they're upset, if things are not going their way, that light is coming on, letting others know, I'm toxic, leave me alone. Very interesting. Now, when we think about the blinking of that light and the chemistry behind that, do all species of fireflies blink the same way, or how does that work? How do you look at that?
It actually turns out that's how the female and males can tell each other apart and what's the right species. Most of the information is probably in how many flashes a male will blink, how the interval is, the time delay between individual flashes.
Interesting.
And the female will watch that closely, and if it matches her expectation, she decides to basically blink back.
Interesting.
Again, the male watches. If that's the right interval, the male keeps coming back, and so it goes back and forth a few times. And the whole idea is to reduce potential mistakes in mating between males and females.
Wow, so it's Morse code, almost like in lights.
That's right.
So I'm standing outside here with KATHRIN. You know, the female fireflies, she was saying, spend a lot of their time in the trees, and I'm trying to signal to them that I'm down here. No, seriously, they wouldn't be out there in the day. But KATHRIN, how are firefly populations doing nationally?
So many people you talk to, they say they're declining. Mm. We see less and less of them.
Okay.
And that's partly due to development, to training of the wetlands that they like to live in, especially as larvae.
Okay.
Around our neighborhoods, it's mostly that we have excessive lighting around our house. So of course that interferes with the signaling of fireflies.
Gotcha.
So what we could do is have simply flashlights that go down, that go down to the ground.
So having lights that are pointing more down toward the ground as opposed to a floodlight that would broadcast light out.
Yes, that would give us safety, but at the same time would protect the fireflies.
Good.
I also would like to limit the certain types of chemicals in the yard.
Okay.
Because firefly larvae, they live on earthworms and on snails. So
okay.
The general rule is whatever keeps those happy, that will nurture the firefly larvae during 2 years, and then you get the adults flashing in your backyard.
Right, so we've got to create this nursery for those babies with earthworms and with the snail. So Doc, thank you so much for spending time with me. Who knew all this? I hope it's been enlightening for you and brightened your day and all this. Y'all, we've had a blast talking about fireflies. Y'all know what to do. Hop online, check out the Farm Monitor on Facebook, and while you're online, check out my Ranger Nick Facebook page. I love it when you do that. We do those Friday fly days every week. Appreciate y'all watching. And of course, as always, for the Farm Monitor, I'm Ranger Nick, reminding you that enthusiasm is contagious. So pass it on. Y'all, thanks so much for watching, and we'll be seeing you when we get back together again next month. See ya.